Prime Minister Narendra Modi has hit back at his detractors and he's targeted the Congress Party Vice President Rahul Gandhi's suit boot ki sarkar jibe. The Prime Minister said that the Congress Party has not been able to digest its crushing defeat in Lok Sabha elections even after 1 year. This is the Prime Minister's most explicit attack on the Congress President Sonia Gandhi. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said that extra constitutional authority had the power in UPA. The Prime Minister did not mince his words. Sonia ruled the UPA government. The Prime Minister said this government, the previous government, was run through a remote control. There was a remote control theory in this straight attack. Prime Minister Modi said Sonia was UPA's remote control. The Prime Minister reacted to Rahul Gandhi's suit boot ki sarkar jibe, saying that the Congress has not been able to digest its crushing defeat in Lok Sabha elections even after 1 year. Let me bring in our executive editor Javed Ansari for more on this. Javed, bring us details. This is the most direct attack that Prime Minister Narendra Modi has launched on Rahul Gandhi, on Sonia Gandhi, on the first anniversary of his government.
Yes, certainly, because Rahul Gandhi has been sniping at Prime Minister Narendra Modi and his government for ever since he's returned from his sabbatical. So it was only to be expected that the Prime Minister would reply in kind. Today he has. Although, you know, when you're a Prime Minister, you have to mince your words. And it's much easier being an opposition leader than being in government. And therefore, Rahul, in the opposition, you have the liberty of making allegations and getting away with it. And you're especially when you're Prime Minister, you need to weigh your words carefully. The Prime Minister has chosen to reply, but he's also weighed his words carefully.
Bring us details of what all the Prime Minister said, Javed. He attacked the Congress, saying that the Congress government hasn't been able to digest its defeat even after 1 year of losing elections. He also launched a frontal attack on the Congress Party President Sonia Gandhi, Javed.
Yes, because, a lot of the reason for the Congress Party's ability to find its feet once again has been Mrs. Gandhi's proactiveness in the time when Rahul was absent. And that has also allowed the Congress Party, congressmen, to get over that psychological hump of the defeat.
Stay with me for a moment, Javed. I also want to bring in Congress's Tom Vadakkan for more on this. Tom Vadakkan, the Prime Minister says extra constitutional authorities were really wielding power in the UPA. And is this not a direct attack on Sonia Gandhi, sir?
I don't know what he means by extra constitutional powers. I want to ask him another question, if you permit me. The RSS, operating from Nagpur, an NGO apparently, cultural NGO, is the remote control of this government. I don't want to go further.
Okay.
Congress President Sonia Gandhi was the president of the Congress Party. The UPA government came to power on the basis of the leadership of Congress President. Certain advisories were given from time to time. That is the responsibility of the Congress Party, and that has been done. RBI, there are various things which I can list out, emanated from the Congress Party.
Is there merit in the Prime Minister's statement, Tom Vadakkan, that he says on the suit boot ki sarkar jibe, that the Congress hasn't been able to digest its defeat even after 1 year?
He needs to perform now. It is not a question of us forgetting or remembering events. It is for him. The jury is out. He needs to tell the nation what he is doing. 200 press conferences on his birthday, technical birthday, to inform the nation what his government has done. The people at ground zero have not seen anything happening. The 16 lakh promise has not arrived. The land acquisition bill threatens to take the land of the farmer.
Tom Vadakkan, I have Sambit Patra of the BJP joining me on the broadcast. Sambit Patra, Tom Vadakkan says, while the Prime Minister may attack the extra constitutional power in the UPA, it's the RSS that has the remote control in this government.
see, Mr. Tom Vadakkam and the Congress has to realize the difference between a compass and a remote control. A remote control is the one which has the controlling authority. The buttons are on the remote control side, whereas a compass is one which is only the guiding light. It has no buttons of controlling. Number two, as far as the Prime Minister talk about the extra constitutional powers wielding its own effect in Congress is concerned, we are all aware of the fact that unseen hands were controlling the hand of the Congress government during that tenure, and the unseen hand was none other than the NAC formed by Sonia Gandhi.
Okay, Tom Varakkan, would you want to respond to that? Sambit Patra says there's a difference between a compass and a remote control, alleging that Sonia Gandhi was the remote control.
Tell Dr. Patra, we don't need X-ray reports to tell us which hand. It was the Congress Party's hand that were helping out the government for a direction. The RTI Act, under which these people thrive. There is no, RTI is being destroyed by them. The RTI was formatted by that hand. You don't need to read an X-ray for that. This is the hand that led the direction. We are proud of the fact. We are not hiding anything. We advise. We set the agenda because we are a party that won elections. The government of the day, it has to be given direction. If a cultural organization like the RSS is giving direction, if a minority minister tells the dietary conditions to be laid out, that if you eat a particular meat, you need to go to Pakistan. If this is what the advisories that are coming in, and what is the functioning of the ministries? None of the ministers are active. The foreign minister is unknown. Where she is and how she is, nobody knows. The prime minister goes abroad. The defense minister is in Goa, fishing, while the deals are being made.
Okay. Sambit, you want to quickly, Sambit Patra, you want to quickly respond to that? That the prime foreign minister unheard where she is. The Congress alleges that defense minister is fishing in Goa.
Look, I mean, the party in which for 10 long years nobody knew where the Prime Minister was and where the whole party was fishing corruption from the pond of the country, they have no rights to be talking such bunkum talk that we are hearing today. As far as extra constitutional authorities controlling the government is concerned, I don't have to speak anything. Even Sanjay Baru has written in his own book that Pulak Chatterjee, the cabinet secretary, every evening used to rush with the files from PMO office to 10 Janpat to get it cleared. Was this constitutional where the PMO office was not clearing policy matters, but it was 10 Janpat which was clearing policy matters?
Clearly, the last hasn't been heard of this. Tom Varakkan, Sambit Patra, for the moment, many thanks for joining me. We will continue to track this story very closely here on India Today.